What do you think is happening?
I think we're at war.
Episode 5, we knew from the time we outlined it, was going to be the biggest episode by a long shot, with two really big set pieces in it. It's explosive, but it starts quietly.
You're the good cop?
Depends who you ask.
Where's the bad cop?
Watching.
For this interrogation, it's fun sort of watching a little bit of the cat and mouse game.
What about Evans? We're right in assuming he's Vera's father.
Only in the biological sense.
There's a real dance that happens between both of them, how they're making their plays with each other on such high-level stakes, really. So you tried to protect her, but it didn't work out, did it?
I think most people, by this point, have sussed out that Vera was probably Evan's daughter. But it just makes you realize the things they're willing to sacrifice. He'd never seen his daughter before. He saw her lying in her coffin. That's a pretty intense revelation delivered in a pretty matter-of-fact way.
Maybe you're not the good cop after all.
Again, we're talking about good guys and bad guys and how hard that is to figure out.
It creates a interesting moral dynamic for the viewer that the most violent, horrific thing that we do on the show is done by ostensibly the good guys.
You have 6 days to complete an engineering project. When you've succeeded, there'll be no medals, no public recognition, no glory. But the next 6 days are the most important ones of your lives.
The Judgment Day sequence in the book was one of those ones that we talked about before, where you just think, oh man, I really want to see that on screen, see it done right.
For something as epic as the Judgment Day, it began with months and months of prep. And I think everyone just expects that you're just going to all do it in post and VFX. And I guess maybe I'm old school, but I wanted to keep quite a bit of it in camera as well.
Why isn't it working?
It is.
We had to figure out exactly which things were going to be added in later with visual effects. The massacred people were added in later, but up until the point when they get sliced and diced, they're human beings. Never seen it before, and when you're imagining it kind of vaguely, and then you get into the details of what you're seeing in any given shot as this is happening, it really helps to sell horror of their decision.
It's terrifying. It's utterly terrifying.
You're telling us to kill people we don't know for reasons that we don't know, and you're just like, yeah, cool?
Everyone in the show is grappling all the time with the question of, in a wartime situation, how far will you go? What human costs are you willing to incur to achieve your objectives? We see our characters, more than anything, they define themselves against each other by the different ways in which they react to this question, what is worth it and how far is too far?
Whereas Augie is horrified, Wade is definitely a ends justify the means sort of guy.
Break a few eggs to make the omelet sort of a guy.
He knows what the job is and he knows what he has to do to accomplish that job. He has a certain morality, with possibly a small M.
Anyway, sorry for your loss, although it sounds like he wasn't much help around the house.
I love Thomas Wyatt. In my mind, he's a good guy.
We summon energies you cannot imagine and focus them on a single proton.
Sophon's explaining a concept, you know, that no one has ever heard before, yeah, of creating a supercomputer within a proton, exploding it into a bunch of higher dimensions, shrinking it back down into a three-dimensional object, and then shooting it off into, yeah, space so that it could wreak havoc on Earth.
We are going to kill your science.
We tried to boil it down to the bare essentials of quantum entanglement, which is a real phenomenon. But everything that's been happening to everybody has been happening because of these things. It's what makes everything possible. And it is also the key point going forward, the answer to the question, why does this matter? Like, they're not gonna be here for 400 years. That's not actually true. They're here now.
A in the books, the "you are bugs" message appears in everyone's field of vision, which would be tricky to do on screen. So in this hyper-technological world we're in, having it appear on every surface and screen, it seemed like a really dramatic visual way of representing the same thing. You see that incredible performance on Ross Chau's face, where everything she believed in has fallen apart. Yet another betrayal in a series of betrayals in her life.
And just when you think, I can't take it anymore, you're pummeled again with another crazy sequence.
Once you see the eye in the sky, it's hard to deny that there is a superior power out there that is coming for us. And then you see Marlo give that great smile.
You write something like laughing and crying at the same time. And then Marlo comes up to you and she goes, normal people don't actually do this. I'm like, well, this is where your ability to be a not normal person between action and cut are gonna really come in handy.
To her, they aren't just an idea or aliens, they are the Lord. So she is a devout follower of them in an almost religious essence.
We felt like if the aliens are going to announce themselves to everybody in the world, they're going to want to do it in a way that shocks people into submission. Letting everybody know in a really visceral way, there's something out there looking at you always. And it does not mean you well. It's a psychological aspect to that. I think both for the people in the show and the people watching the show, it helps set the stakes of what's going on.